Hey, good morning. It's probably around 8:30 in the morning, day three, Christmas Day, December 25th. I stayed at an inn on the lake in Picton, Ontario, and this is my view. Now, this is supposedly the lake. It is frozen, but yeah. And oh, I forgot to tell you that there was a snowstorm overnight, and people are cleaning up the mess it created. So yeah, I'll check out and start our next stop. It is a Birdhouse City, so a community of birdhouses. So it will be interesting. Hopefully the storm didn't mess it too much so that we can enjoy it. Catch you later when I'm checked out. So here we are, Bird City. Now the snow is not feet deep anymore. Get you a bit. It's actually knee deep, so I can't go further than this. But you see, houses that is. These are replicas of real houses in real life. I actually tried going in and I fell knee deep in the snow. So this is as far as I can go with this. I'll just zoom in on the houses so you can see the detail in them. Deeper and deeper in there into the land. Now the winter storm that was last night was a lot worse than the one I was driving in, so I'm happy that it was overnight and it's done with. Picton, Ontario. Population 4,000. That's not far. But it's a beautiful city though. Or town. Alright, let me take some pictures and check out my next.
Hey, so the next stop, apparently there's a shoreline that on the lake that keeps getting eaten up by sand dunes, and lands are shifted away. So it's a phenomenon that they keep realigning the roads because the shoreline keeps getting closer and closer to what it is. So yeah, it's a provincial park where the sand on the beach keeps turning into dunes and eating up the shoreline. So let's see what that is. Okay, so here we are, Sandbanks National Park. And there is our snowmobile. Look how beautiful that is. they actually maintain the roads. Like, it's not just a park. Yeah, it's important for tourists and everything. Amazing. I don't know. We're still in Ontario, people. Closer to the sand dunes. So of course the park is closed, but I'm walking to the beach. Look at how beautiful this is. Like a winter wonderland. They already cleaned up this road a bit, so I can actually walk to the beach and show you how beautiful the beach is. You're not gonna see the sand because the snow is on the ground, but this is the shoreline that keeps on descending. Morning. There is actually construction to bring back the beach. It's probably descending over there. Realigning the beach. Okay, so our next stop is apparently some big blob of stone that was back from, like, how do I explain this? Basically, it was created from the last ice age, and from the ground that keeps melting, and I guess with the global warming and everything, this big rock has risen from the ground as the snowy ground keeps melting and melting, and geological processes happen with the stone. I guess rising from the ground, as the ground gets lower and lower, this big rock was created, and it's a natural phenomenon as well, and it's maintained, and it's apparently a conservatory site. So let's check it out. apparently the pictures look pretty good. So we'll head there. It's an hour away. Hopefully the roads have cleared up to get there in an hour. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Okay, after walking for a kilometer or so, I think we have arrived at the site of that huge stone. They are called boulders. It's basically mineral, huge structures that are formed by melting grounds. So there you go. First thing, it had caves in it, so let me see. It. Oh. Wow, it's huge. Let me step back, not in the snow though. Deeper snow around here. Okay. This is how huge it is. It's called Glenmiller Boulder. It is the biggest of that phenomena. And apparently farmers in the old days didn't like these structures because they will mess up their crops and rise up from the soil. And this is another beautiful land and forest. I can still hear the birds chirping, so there is life here. Okay. Let me take some pictures and walk the kilometer back. Okay, so we're still in Trenton, Ontario. So Trenton being an army base community, our next stop is the National Air Force Museum. Of course, it's Christmas Day, so it is closed. But I thought I can get some nice pictures. You can see my background with all those planes, warplanes. Let me turn the camera. Now, they say they have a replica of the tunnel that the Air Force used in the World War for the Great Escape, where only six people came out alive. And they also have bricks in the ground as a memory of all the fallen soldiers. I believe there's 600 of them in there. Yeah, I wish it wasn't Christmas Day so we would have checked it out even more. But this is as far as we go. Let me take some pictures and off we go. Okay, our next stop, I had to drive an hour in the countryside to Alderville First Nation territory. It's a native area to basically for
that served in the world. Is a waterway that's very distinct. They call it the boat highway. You see behind me here. It lifts the boats across using a hydraulic system that's the biggest of its kind. No power needed. It just fills up with water, and the water tank can pull the boat's weight. It's huge, as you can see. Field. Not sure what the road that is. But it's the biggest in North America to use that mechanism. Mechanism and how it works, but usually it lifts the boat to the other side. It's a hydraulic lock system, basically. It's hard to describe how it works, but yeah. This is the Kirkfield Waterway. It's a boat lift, basically. Or a boat highway. Literally a highway for boats. Alright, let me take some pictures and we can move on. Okay, so it's about to get dark. I'm heading to Buckhorn, Ontario, where my next stop will be. Gonna pit stop at a hotel there, but driving through these farmland and open spaces, you see signs of or saying caution, active flames. What they mean by flames is blown snow that looks like, I guess, icy flames that can mess up your visibility. I'm not sure if you can see it in the video or not, but yeah, that's the number one challenge right now. Snow blowing left and right and acting like a fog. So yeah. We're driving slow, and I have my partner here. We're keeping each other safe. And yeah, it's, I think, 35 minutes till my next stop, so it's not a long drive. So yeah, I'm gonna wrap things up today and concentrate on driving. See ya.